Welcome back to the yard, the Naval Academy in Annapolis, and the lights have gone out. You may have noticed that just as we went to a commercial break and the teams changed ends, a whole grid of lights on both sides went out, and we've seen nothing of them coming back on. There's Colin Campbell. He's in charge of trying to figure out what's going on here, and Gary Bettman's on the phone wondering what has happened and how can we get this fixed, because everything had gone perfectly until just now.
Yeah, you think of all the challenges that they had yesterday and the day before with the high winds and the bad rain, and to come through that and just the 10-minute mark, the whistle goes, the change sides, and bang, just like that.
And no sign of them coming back on yet.
Jim, takes me back to 1988, the Stanley Cup.
Yeah.
Finals in Boston Garden. Lights went out there, and lots of puzzled looks by players and coaches alike. And if you're the Capitals, a 5-2 lead, you got 10 to go, you're just trying to get this thing to the finish line.
They managed it perfectly. They've given up 3 shots in 10 minutes, keeping the Leafs to the outside. Oftentimes in these stadiums, the lights, once they come back on, have to take a while, and we're told that that is the case here. It takes a while for them to get up to full power. So we might be 5 or 10 minutes at least if the lights come back on here before they're at full power.
Yeah, you take it for granted in all the new NHL buildings. They're just instantaneous when they off and on, and it's a beautiful, picturesque night. You got a full moon in the background, but this is a real difficult thing to handle for these two teams. 1,000 lights enough to get these guys back playing again?
Now, as long as this doesn't take too awfully long, people will remember
enjoy themselves
the moment that the lights went out and the phones came on. But on the ice, there's not a chance that you could play the game right now. Players can't see the puck, and in particular, the goaltenders would be messed up in a big way. You notice that around the rink here, it is designed, the platform around the rink is designed as an aircraft carrier.
Well, lots of incredible historical storytelling in this building. Up the far end, all the plaques that are on the walls are just tell the incredible history of the Naval Academy and the Marines.
The stadium was built in the 50s. The Naval Academy started out as just a few acres with just a few students. In 1845, it became the Naval Academy. In 1850, and now it has 300 acres and 4,000 students. Alex Ovechkin's night has been a pretty good one. His line has been the most effective. Their second line is Kuznetsov, who doesn't shoot the puck very much, and TJ Oshie hasn't been able to get many on the net, so they've really relied on Ovechkin on his own. The lights are still out, the big ones. The little ones are shining bright. We'll be back to the Naval Academy in Annapolis.
The Islander. Tavares. Oh, there's a little power outage, and the whistle goes right away. And Forsberg is really happy John Tavares didn't shoot that puck.
That does not happen very often here at the United Center. And it went real dark in a hurry, but just as quickly the lights back on.
Funny though, I mean, really just the LED lights that light up the ice surface about all that went out. I mean, you can still see
We didn't see that, but you're right, the Devils have had an opportunity to put a little heat on Cam, but they shot wide, and I don't know if that's just a case of trying too hard, being a little nervous and not wanting to put it on net, just trying to hit a corner. The players say, let's start by hitting the middle of the net, and then let's work to the corners.
2.25 to go, and the fans are starting to stand here. The lights have gone out.
Marty Brodeur was motioning to the bench. Should I come here with 2 minutes to go? Pull the goalie early? I think he wanted to. And it looked like the Devils might accommodate him, but then the lights went dim.
We will ask down in the production truck, which is outside the arena. There has been some thunderous weather going on outside. And we'll ask our friends downstairs whether that is still happening. There were
Warnings for severe storms, high winds, lots of rain here, and hail today.
And a tornado until 10 o'clock.
Apparently it's just drizzling now is the report from downstairs, and the power has come back on. I thought we were back in Boston Garden. We mentioned that earlier. Well, 2:10 to go in the third period. And at this point, the chance taking would have to involve the goalkeeper, I would think.
Yeah, Marty Brodeur's got a hit to the bench here once the Devils gain control. And they did put five more, they should have put a couple of seconds on. Marty's still slamming his stick, trying to get the attention of the bench. Yeah, Lou Lamoriello and John McClain says, yeah, you come when we get control.